Dear students, very good morning. And as you know, chemistry continues and you are attending already today. Chapter name, to acid, base and salt, you all know. And today we are attending our lecture number 3. Okay? Now, my dear student, before we start lecture number 3 today, let's have a little revival of what we have studied in the previous 2 lectures. As you all know, in the previous 2 lectures, I gave you an idea about general information of acid, base and salt, general information about natural sources of acid, base and salt. At the same time, we also discussed regarding lecture 2, I specially gave just for the indicator, you know that? Why I completely assigned that lecture for indicator, I explain you the importance of that. Lots of diversified variety of MCQs, one line can be designed from that. At that time, if you can remember, I also mentioned name of 4 synthetic indicator, 2 phenolphthalein and methyl orange are already in textbook, but I mentioned 2 other also. Can you remember? That is methyl red and methylene blue. That also you can remember as synthetic indicators. Now, my dear student, today in lecture number 3, we are going to study about chemical properties of acid and base. That we want to study. Actually, the topic yesterday, the topic in lecture number 2, where I gave you an idea about indicators, olfactory indicators, that was actually one of the chemical understanding of chemical properties of acid and base only. In textbook it is mentioned as activity 2.1.1. All type of experiment, color change, we prepared a table, then I explained some olfactory indicators, the natural order changes that I already explained you, that you know very well. Now, my dear student, today let us try to understand some other chemical properties of acid and base. So today we are understanding the topic 2.1. actually we started it, chemical properties of acid and base. In that 2.1.1, that we discussed about indicators yesterday, if you can remember, we just discussed about indicators. That was activity 2.1.1, where I gave you an idea regarding various indicator, naturally available indicator, then some artificial or synthetic indicators, and I gave you at the same time idea about olfactory indicators. Understood? That was our 2.1.1. Now today, my dear student, we are going to understand regarding chemical properties of acid and base. Different type of activities has been given in textbook. Let us try to understand each and every activity in detail. So today our topic is 2.1.2. That is, this 2 activity we already discussed. Now today we are discussing 2.2.2, name, number doesn't matter so much. What matters is the content, understand, of the topic, what we are going to understand today. Let me first make the title of that. We are to, in today's lecture, we are understanding reaction of acid and base with metals. This is our target today when we start. Reaction of acid and base with metal. This is the chemical property we are going to discuss. Reaction of acid and base with metal. My dear student, one thing I should mention, no doubt, it has been explained in the textbook as one of the activity, one of the experiment where they have set an apparatus. Diagram in biology may be difficult, in chemistry so it's quite simple. Actually, before I explain you this activity, how acid and base react with metal, I just want to mention some generalized word equation of reaction of acid and base with metal. Do you remember generalized word equation? You know, let me write that generalized word equation for you. Whenever acid react with metal, whenever, I am writing the word equation. Can you remember the word equation? Right? No? When acid react with metal, I am writing the general property first. When acid react with metal, it produces salt and hydrogen gas. This is the general word equation to describe reaction of acid with metal. When acid react with metal, it forms salt and hydrogen. Actually, you can mention respective salt, that you can mention, no problem at all. Respective salt, because, athwa you can write respective salt, or you can write metallic salt, all okay? Okay, so whenever acid react with metal, to describe it in general format, understand, in one line if asked, what happens when acid react with metal, just explain in one line, so how will you write? When metal react with acid, it forms respective metallic salt and produces hydrogen gas. You understood this? This is the general word equation I just explained. Note down karo and you speak with me. Acid react with metal, it produces respective metallic salt and produces hydrogen gas. If I want to write the same word equation for base, yes, it applies. When base react with metal, similar thing, they also produces, I am not writing respective metallic, you all know, they produce is salt and they release hydrogen gas. You understood this? So just to confine in way, if in one line asked what happens, acid or base react with metal, so my dear student, in one line answer what you can write: when acid and base react with metal, they produces respective metallic salt and produces hydrogen gas. This is the basic concept of understanding of this activity. Activity title is reaction of acid and base with metal. So suppose in exam you are asked, in homework also if I give, describe reaction of acid and base with metal. So my dear student, you should not start directly with activity. You should write the general statement first. What is that? Whenever acid and base react with metal, I am speaking it again so that you can note down. Understand? Whenever acid and base react with metal, they produces respective metallic salt and hydrogen gas. This is a generalized statement which you can write. Understand? Suppose in activity, if we want to just mention you, this has been clear in your mind. Suppose let us try to perform an experiment. Suppose my dear student, you take one test tube. Suppose test tube is taken. Okay, suppose you take one test tube. Okay, and in that test tube, suppose you have to close it with rubber cork already. Okay, and in this test tube, suppose it has to be closed by rubber cork. Okay, one hole rubber cork. In this test tube, you have to take a mixture of one metal, because we are going to study the reaction of acid and metal. So obviously one metal has to be taken. And my dear student, you are performing this experiment in laboratory. So when you perform any experiment in laboratory, you always want the rate of reaction to become faster. If I take metal pieces, then the rate of reaction would be definitely slow. So rather than I take a metal pieces, I will take it in either powder or granular form ultimately. So suppose we have to select any one metal. Suppose we take zinc metal here. Okay, zinc metal means I have taken zinc granule. This is zinc granule. Granular form, એટલે you know, a powder type of granular form. This is a zinc granules I should mention. Zinc granules. And I have also taken at the same time here dilute, suppose sulfuric acid. This is what I am showing. Dilute sulfuric acid. Because you perform experiment in laboratory under the teacher's assistant and observation, then also it is a general guidance not to take concentrated form of acid. Dilute acid we have taken. So here in test tube we have taken a mixture of what? Zinc granules and dilute HCl. what happens to note down the observation, let us, my dear student, take one delivery tube. Understand, suppose here I take some one vessel. In chemistry, so you can draw diagram, okay, it's all okay, understand. Suppose we have taken soap solution in this, and here one delivery tube is there. Delivery tube will carry the gas produced from here up to the salt solution, okay. Suppose this is delivery tube, okay. Delivery tube. Okay, taking gas produced up to the vessel which is filled with soap solution. Suppose this is the vessel. Understand, this vessel is already filled with soap solution. Understood? Suppose this is delivery tube and we have filled the vessel with soap solution. Why is not water and soap solution? So that the produced gas will form bubbles. We all know one thing very well, that hydrogen gas is actually, what you know, insoluble in water. So how we detect? It is odorless, colorless. How can we detect whether the production of hydrogen gas has taken place? So that becomes possible only by soap solution. When the hydrogen gas come here, it will form bubbles. Okay, now try to understand. Observation. Now what happens, my dear student? These are some apparatus, arrangement, stand and all things that you can draw easily. It doesn't matter much. Now what happens? What we have taken, this is one test tube already. Okay, or hard glass tube also. This is glass tube apparatus. This can be called a delivery tube. Understand? Delivery tube always carry gas, understand, from one vessel to another vessel. And here we have taken what? That is soap solution. Okay, my dear student, these are soap solution we have taken. Now actually, what happens? Let us record our observation. What happens? What we have taken in this hard glass tube, we have taken zinc powder, actually granular forms, and dilute HCl. There is no need to heat them because they automatically instantly start reacting with each other at normal room temperature. Understand, no need to supply any heat. They start reacting with each other at normal room temperature and produces hydrogen gas. Ultimately, I told you the hydrogen gas which is produced from here by reaction of these two hydrogen gas. This hydrogen gas will travel in this delivery tube. See, I am showing it. Hydrogen gas will travel in this delivery tube and reach to the soap solution. But as I told you, hydrogen is insoluble in water. The moment it reach to the soap solution, it start forming bubbles. Understand? And these bubbles can be seen this way. Hydrogen bubbles are formed. And this bubble also start coming out. These are actually hydrogen bubbles, which suggests actually the production of hydrogen gas. You can fill hydrogen gas in any container and you can check its properties. As you all know, it is colorless gas, odorless gas, and one property itself is implied from here, that it is insoluble in water, otherwise it haven't has formed the bubbles. It would have dissolved in the soap solution which is prepared in water, but actually does not occur. Hydrogen gas is insoluble in water and it formed bubbles. It is seen in the form which is coming out of soap solution. Three properties, production of hydrogen gas has already been clear in your mind. First, colorless, odorless, not seen, no smell, no odor is felt. It is insoluble in water, that's why it does not dissolve in soap solution, but it forms bubbles and come out in the form of bubbles. Now, as you all know, okay, hydrogen is inflammable. It immediately burns. Okay, how can you check it? Suppose, my dear student, suppose I draw one bubble here. Just take an example. This hydrogen bubbles which are coming out, okay? Suppose one hydrogen bubble is there. The moment I bring burning matchstick near it, actually, right? Suppose a burning candle, chalo na. Or burning matchstick or burning candle, whatever, if I bring near this burning matchstick, okay, or burning candle, what happens? Hydrogen is already, you know, that hydrogen is inflammable gas and it possesses high calorific value around approximately 150 kilojoule per gram. So the moment burning candle or burning matchstick is brought near, understand, this bubble, it start, means it blast, understand, with crackling sound, understand, it burst with crackling sound. Why the crackling sound is heard? Because the hydrogen is inflammable and it starts burning quickly, understand? So what happens? Hydrogen gas starts burning with crackling or popping sound, understand? So that suggests the production of hydrogen gas already. So my dear student, this activity itself implies that whenever any metal react with acid, it produces hydrogen gas. You understood this? Production of hydrogen gas can take place whenever any acid react with metal. To just generalize and write the equation, word equation we have already written here. You note it down with me. Just to mention the equation for this, my dear student, it's quite simple. Let us mention equation here. Chalo. Should I rub this? You all know which topic is continuing, so that you know. Understood. Actually, what happened, that acid reacted with metal and it produced respective salt and hydrogen gas. Here, not only hydrogen gas comes out, but after the reaction get over, whatever produced here will be a particular salt of respective metal which we have taken here. We have taken which metal here? Zinc. So some aqueous solution of zinc salt is to be formed here. To mention it in the form of word equation, actually skeletal, not skeletal, balanced chemical equation. Let me write. I am writing chemical equation here. You can note down in your book just below it. Understand? Suppose zinc. We have taken zinc granule in solid form, that you all know, my dear student, zinc granules are taken. Zinc granules, and what is added here? Dilute HCl. So when I am speaking the word dilute, I have to mention aqua here, because concentrated form of acid we generally avoid to utilize in laboratory, to avoid any type of danger which may take place due to the negligence of the student at that time. Understand, that's why dilute HCl is taken here. Zinc, why S? Because we have taken zinc powder, that we have taken zinc in granular form. Okay. Now zinc is already taken in granular form, HCl in dilute form. Understand, my dear student, now what happens when reaction take place between zinc and HCl? It forms, as I told you, respective salt. So obviously zinc is reacting with dilute hydrochloric acid, so product will be zinc chloride. Understand, and it produces hydrogen gas. Now, my dear student, you mentioned the state, zinc chloride obviously aqueous form and hydrogen in gaseous form, and to write just a balanced chemical equation, my dear student, it is damn simple. Just you write two here, enough. So this is what we have written, a chemical equation to demonstrate this activity. Understand, to demonstrate this activity, I have already written a chemical equation already here. So this activity has been clear in your mind. We have understood what? We have understood reaction of acid with metal. Suppose in homework I ask you, describe reaction of metal with acid. So how will you start your answer? First point, I want generalized explanation from you. What is that generalized explanation? When acid react with metal, I am not talking of base, when acid react with metal, it forms respective metallic salt and produces hydrogen gas. Okay, general explanation is over. Then second sentence, what you write? Let us perform an activity to understand how the reaction take place between acid and metal. Then, my dear student, understand that, so you can draw. Understand, not much important. Take one hard glass tube, test tube, also bigger test tube is enough. What then you can write that, make some arrangement of apparatus as shown in the figure. First you draw the figure and then you write. In glass tube we have taken metal, zinc metal in granular form. What I am suggesting, granular form, that is in powdered form. Understand, why in powdered form? Because the rate of reaction can become faster and will not waste our time. Then we have taken dilute HCl here. Understand, this is the arrangement. In another vessel, soap solution taken, and there is a delivery tube which transfer gas produced in glass tube to the vessel containing soap solution. These are this is what the activity is about, an observation. After some time, next point you can write, after some time the reaction starts between acid and zinc granule, and within a short period of time around zinc granule some bubbles are seen. They were of hydrogen gas. Hydrogen gas come out from delivery tube up to the salt or soap solution. When it comes to the soap solution, actually hydrogen gas is odorless, colorless. So we have kept a soap solution here so that the bubbles of hydrogen gas are formed and it come out from the vessel in the form of hydrogen bubble. Actually, it is hydrogen gas that can be identified only by that that experiment of bringing burning matchstick or burning candle near the bubbles, because otherwise many other gases are also colorless and odorless, maybe insoluble in water also. So this doesn't imply that this is the only test for hydrogen. What we bring from near one bubble, let us try to bring some burning matchstick or burning candle. The moment you bring burning matchstick or burning candle, hydrogen, as you know, is highly inflammable gas, highly inflammable. So immediately when you bring burning matchstick or burning candle near it, it starts bursting with popping sound, crackling sound. Understand? So this is the way you can explain that acid, when react with metal, it produces respective salt and hydrogen gas. Here, this activity can be represented in short form by one balanced chemical equation. ZnS plus 2HCl aqua give ZnCl2 aqua plus H2 gas. This is the way hydrogen gas is produced. You understood this, okay? So my dear student, here one thing is clear: when acid metal, it produces hydrogen gas and respective salt. When acid, that is dilute HCl, reacted with zinc, it produces zinc chloride salt and at the same time produce hydrogen gas. Is the same activity occurring with base also? Yes, my dear student. Instead of dilute HCl here, if I would have taken one of the base, suppose one base I take sodium hydroxide NaOH, if I would have taken sodium hydroxide base, same reaction might have taken place, same hydrogen bubbles might have formed, because reaction of base with metal also results in the production of hydrogen gas. Let us just try to write the equation, my dear student. You must be knowing this chemical equation already. Let us do it. All apparatus arrangement, I may give you in PDF, it will be as other question. No? Describe reaction of base with metal. So everything you have to mention in the same way. Instead of dilute HCl, what you have to mention? NaOH, sodium hydroxide. No need to take it in dilute format, you all know. Understand? Even if you take in dilute format, then also the chemical reaction will take place. But there is no need, because acids are harmful and that's why they are taken in dilute form. Base are not harmful and they are not highly inflammable, cause any burns. So base can be taken as it is, okay? So you take base in liquid form, joy base, and zinc granule, same reaction, same explanation you have to make. Only change occur in, that is just in chemical reaction. I am just erasing it, 2.2.2, you all know. Understand, this is also, you know. Just one change which I want to mention is that is only the chemical equation, my dear student. Can we write it now? Okay, suppose zinc as it is, this is what I am describing, reaction of metal with base plus I write NaOH, okay? NaOH. I am not mentioning anything here. Why? Because I told you just now, no need for taking dilution form of base because they are not so strong and harmful. So base can be taken in liquid as it is without its dilution in water. Okay. So I am just writing liquid, it's all okay. When reaction takes place between zinc and sodium hydroxide, what it forms? The respective salt. Understand, name of that salt is sodium zincate. Let me write Na2ZnO2. Understand, that's the salt formed by reaction, just balancing matter. The 2 is enough. And it also produces what? Hydrogen gas in the same manner. Name of this you should remember. Understand, what is that? Sodium zincate. One particular salt is formed here. I am just mentioning the name sodium zincate. And hydrogen gas is also produced at the same time. So reaction with of acid and base with metal, my dear student, quite easy to understand. Same activity, only change in equation. And here either you take dilute HCl, but in place when you describe reaction of base with metal, what you have to take? You have to take NaOH. Understand, NaOH, sodium hydroxide. Understand, solution you have to take. Understood? One more thing, my dear student. This reaction which I mentioned here, where sodium hydroxide react with zinc, you must know one thing very clear, that this chemical reaction is not possible with all metals, mind it. It is possible with some highly reactive metals only. It is not possible with all metals. That you should mention, that this reaction is not possible with all metals. Okay, so my dear student, before we end today's lecture, today lecture number 3, where I explained you activity 2.2.2, that is a reaction between acid and metal, base and metal, 2.1.1, that was general discussion about chemical property of acid base, discussion about indicators. And today activity 2.2.2, that is reaction of acid and base with metals, that I explained. Okay, so third lecture today. As you all know, my dear student, before we end the lecture, chapter number 2, that is acid, base and salt, 3 lectures already. First lecture just confined for giving you some idea about acid, base and salt, their general property and general discussion, and giving you an idea regarding the natural sources of acid, base and salt. Then, my dear student, in the next lecture, I gave the whole lecture for the explanation of only indicators. And then we started our discussion regarding chemical properties of acid base. Today in this lecture I explained you activity 2.2.2, that is the reaction between acid and base with metal. My dear student, in lecture why I discuss activities in quite detail, so that any MCQ, any one line may be asked from activity, so your understanding of activity needs to be very very sure and certain, so any MCQ regarding this can be asked, you are able to answer them perfectly. Okay, this is clear. So let us end today's lecture. Thank you very much from Bharat sir.